there are three main things that have dominated Christianity across the world. The first is the authority of the scriptures.
I don't know whether in your life today there are things that have caused you so much anxiety.
That if you give your life to Jesus Christ, you are no longer an ordinary person.
What is the use of rain for a farmer who will not plant?
We need to radiate the glory of God.
That you will wax great and you will go forward and grow until you become great.
Coming to the glory is to give your life to Jesus.
Month, the transformation of wealth. We have started seeing it already. God is not an author of confusion. Everything God says, He confirmed. The door has been opened. I pity for those of you who will not keep to it. But I'm assuring you, if you will follow this month, nothing will pass you by. I said, nothing will pass you by. Your month. How can you carry pregnancy for 10 months? It's abnormal. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
It's abnormal.
Yes.
You have been expecting something from January to date. You have been looking for something from January to date. You have been finding application from one office to the other. You have got a lot of suitors. You have got a lot of proposals. You have read a lot of jobs and a lot of businesses. But no one is coming out. But this month, somebody say this month.
This month.
Say this month.
This month.
Say this month.
This month.
I must receive my own. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Talk to your neighbor and say, you are blessed to be here today. I don't know what your neighbor is saying. If he doesn't want to say it, say it to yourself, I am blessed to be here today. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I want to thank every one of you here. Nobody come to the presence of God and go back the same.
Amen.
As you have left every other business to come to attend to the business of God, God will meet you. Because as our faces are different, so our problems and difficulties. And He knows that which pains you. And He will grant you that honest desire today.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. I'm bringing special greetings to you today from Worldwide Outreach Germany, where we'll fight and make sure we bring our generation to Christ. Hallelujah. I'm so excited to be in your midst today. It's a privilege given to me, and I take it all for granted. To my most senior brother and to our mama, thank you very much. I truly appreciate the God who has called you into His ministry. Will continue to lift you, or will raise you, and put you in where you do not expect. I want to thank every pastor, every man and woman of God in this house, everybody who is serving in one capacity or the other, every work you are doing here, even if the pastor is not seeing you, I want you to understand that you are not working for the pastor, neither for mama, but you are working for God. And at the appropriate time, at the 9 months,
Amen.
You will receive yours.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
It's so sad and painful that I don't have so much time, although I have a lot, but by His grace, we will see how we manage it, and I believe we will be able to get somewhere good today.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You are looking so weak and so cold. This is what I call testimony. The grace to function without struggle being put into action is what I regarded as testimony. Do you know how many times people who are building house can testify to this? You come to the site, the water will not be there. Big layer will miss it, they will abandon the split and run away. They will come today, they will do one place. Tomorrow they will come, they will crack it down. You will come, you have headache, you have cold, and yet nothing is working. They will come and collect money and they will run away. They will not come to your work. All those things, God saved my sister from those things.
Hallelujah!
And gave her a house.
Amen.
Even from the original price. He called the man, he said, you see, you say, okay, bring 1.5 million. Come on, somebody. Is that God not worthy to be praised? This is just the beginning of the month.
Amen.
And just look at the testimony that is starting the month. I don't know about you, but if I'm in your shoes, I'm going to position myself. I'm going to focus. And I'm going to make sure that I follow this month carefully. Because any pregnant woman after 9 months is still pregnant is not normal. Any pregnant woman after 9 months is still pregnant. Is that normal?
No.
Praise God. Transferring of weight. What you labored for. My brother, God bless you, Richard. Of God in you, put that into you. That is to say, the weight of the Gentiles, God will transfer it to you. It is, you see, so many times when we say certain things, people don't understand. As I was praying about this topic this morning, the Spirit of God ministered to me. He said, that is a very powerful one. But do you know not everybody is going to receive it?
Yes, sir.
I said, God, but why? He said, it is not everybody that will receive it. And I looked at myself, I said, but why? He said, those, the problem why so many of you are not going to receive it today, or before this month will run end. The problem is not what that person, but who? You.
Yourself.
Who?
Yourself.
Who?
Yourself.
Man of God, they don't know me, let me tell you my principle. If I minister and I ask a simple question that I know that you know, you know, and I know that you know, and I ask you a question and you don't answer, it means you are telling me, man of God, we are adding 10 minutes to your time. So when I ask you a simple question that I know that you know, and you do not answer me, man of God, take note, I add extra 10 minutes to my time. I'm watching the time. Hallelujah! It's so unfortunate that I came from a country where we are paid according to our hours. So we work by hours, and when we have surplus hour, we are always excited because we have extra money. So if I'm working for God and I have extra hours, I'll be so glad to have it. Hallelujah, somebody. Praise the Lord. You may be in the wrong location for too long, but this morning I come to announce to you, God has remembered you. You will be here, sitting down, under the sound of my voice. You will be wondering, why does this man know about me? I don't need to know nothing about you. God needs to know all that concerns you. Because he's the one that is going to perfect it. Hallelujah. The month of September. The month you need to push. So this is not the month you need to run to pastor. This is not the month you need to complain. This is not the month that you need to be looking for excuses. This is the month that you need to be you. And one of the first reasons why those who are not going to deliver this month will not deliver is miss your way. Miss your way. One, miss your way. When you are traveling, let me use a different location here. Let's assume we are going to Lagos and the road is directly this way and we decide to travel this direction. Are we going to get to Lagos?
No, sir.
Are we going to get to Lagos?
No, sir.
Come on, somebody. When God called the children of Israel to leave the land of Egypt, he has a purpose for them. Is that true?
Yes, sir.
How many days was in the plan of God for the children of Israel to leave Egypt to the promised land?
40 days.
How many years would it take the children of Israel to get to the promised land?
40 years.
Who missed his way?
The children of Israel.
Do they get there?
Yes.
No. No. Not even one soul that left Egypt.
No, let God there.
Not even one. So prophecy can come on your life. Man of God can speak unto your life, he can prophesy to you. It doesn't mean the man has lied, he has told you the truth. But because you have not positioned yourself to receive, you will not get it.
Yes, sir, that's right.
When you miss your way, you will not get to the location.
Yes.
Unless you have to turn around. It may mean a new beginning. But you have to turn around, you have to change. That is why the first point here is missed. So many people in the Bible have missed their way. But bless God that some of them didn't find it fit and reposition themselves and they get to their destination. So many never get to their destination. Some of you know so many of them here. King Solomon, King David, Samson, Judas Iscariot, Peter. They all missed their way. But some of them were able to reposition themselves and they got to their destination. I don't know why I'm talking to this morning. I don't know how far you must have gone in the wrong direction. But I am convinced within my spirit by the power of God that is present in this house. If only you will turn around. If only you will follow this month of the ninth month of September. If only you will push. If only you will not be stubborn. If only you will not argue. If only you will not bring unnecessary debate. If only you will listen to the voice of the children, of the prophets of God, and you will walk in direction and in line according to the word of God. I said, this is your month. If not for time, I would have loved to break it down. But because of time, I'm just going to give you some scriptural backing for those of you who are taking notes, to please take note. But before I go further, there are some principles I would want to kindly discuss with you. Permit me 1 minute. Church, what is this? What is it? God bless you. What is this? God bless you. What is this?
Bible.
Thank you very much. This is phone, right?
Yes, sir.
This is phone, right?
Yes, sir.
We have the Bible in the phone, right?
Yes, sir.
Do we have the phone in the Bible?
No, sir.
Good. In the same phone, we have what is called WhatsApp, right?
Yes, sir.
We have Twitter, right?
Yes, sir.
We have Facebook, right? Don't pretend as if you don't know it. Say it.
Yes,
we have
Facebook, Instagram.
Instagram.
Yeah.
Messenger.
Messenger.
God bless you all. Amen.
Amen.
And you know, when you come to church, you will hold this one and say, this is your Bible. You say, this is what? Your Bible. Is this your Bible?
No, sir.
You don't know, maybe on your way coming to the church, somebody will see you because you carry the Bible. He said, where are you going? And already you have preached the gospel.
Hallelujah.
Who will see you with a phone and ask you where you are going? Who? Do you know, even as you are sitting here now, you are trying to tap the page so that you look. One fast message we just call smart chat. You say, let me reply fast. You want to reply fast. And as the time you reply that message, another one. By the time you finish that one, another one. At the end of the day, you miss your purpose of coming to church. Do you know God can even kill you for that? Hey, you don't know the God we are talking about. You know that?
Oh, yes. So
please, I am begging you. Don't carry this here and say, this is your Bible. Are you hearing me?
Oh, yeah.
Don't carry this here and say, this is your what?
Bible.
You have the Bible. Take note. Number two, I want to tell you something very brief. How many of you have been to the lockup? You've been there. God, thank you. God bless you. At least what I'm going to say now is not new to you. You have experience. If you go to the law court, number one principle, as you enter the court, if a judge is already in sitting, you don't talk to anybody. Is that true?
Yes.
Is that true?
Yes.
Those who have been to the court, is that true?
Yes, sir.
Number two, when you are in the law court, you are not allowed to use your handy. Is that true?
Yes, sir.
Is that true?
Yes, sir.
Good. Now, we are talking about a judge, a human being, sitting here, and you are playing this respect. Number three, do you know you are not allowed to chew gum in the lockup?
Yes.
You know that?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so many of you have not been there. Sorry, you don't know. I don't pray that. I pray you go there for a good purpose, so that you know what I'm talking about. So when you come to the presence of the judge, who created the universe, the omnipotent, the omniscient, the I am that I am, the man that needed no concept of any man to have created you, you come to his presence and you need somebody to remind you how to behave yourself. You need somebody to discipline you. Come on, somebody. I wouldn't mind if this is the only message I preach today. Heaven will be happy with you. When you come to the presence of God, coordinate yourself.
Thank you, sir.
Behave yourself. You have come to receive from God. Before you came, God is already present to present present to those who are
present.
So now this accountable for receiving from God. Hallelujah! Praise the Lord! As I was talking about the topic for today, about the ninth month. And there are key factors. I would have loved to take it wider, but because of time, I won't go too deep. But I want to look at four reasons why you yourself will not be among those who will come and give testimony before the end of this month.
It doesn't mean that it is limited. When you say something is abundant, it means it's surplus. Is that not true? Yesterday, I don't know where you were, but where I was, it was raining heavily. And as it was raining, I refused to come outside to put my bucket or my basin in the rain. And so for that reason, I did not fetch any water from the rain. Does that stop the rain from falling? That you refuse to receive your blessing does not make it only a limited blessing. The blessing is already in abundance, but it is all left for you to position yourself and listen carefully and follow the word of God, dot by dot, line by line, and you will receive yours. That's why in the book of Deuteronomy 26, when Moses, God was speaking to them, he said, if you follow my decree, not a little to the left, not a little to the right. If you follow it, he was talking to Joshua. The way I guide your father Moses, that is how I will guide you. So if you come to the church of God, if you listen to the word of God, and you follow the word of God, the way it is, not sin is being painted and decorated and presented to men as a way of life. I tell people, the day a man of God start preaching to you, not something from the Bible, carry your Bible and leave. Because today we have people who call God. We have a lot of people who call God. We have a lot of little doctors who are into ministry today. We have a lot of wizards. They are into the ministry. And their purpose and their aim is clear. They have come to deceive, to mislead, to destroy. John Peter said, Satan the devil came to kill, to steal, and to destroy. And he has sent also his ministers to go into the churches. And today they are in the churches. They are part of us. There are some of you here who are sitting here. You did not come because you want to receive. You have come to provoke some people to receive. So I don't pray that you die. I pray that you will quicken my testimony in the name of Jesus.
I
said
that the guy for 20 years. Does that make you a guy?
No.
Do you understand the question?
Yes, sir.
I parked myself inside garage where my car is, and I stayed there for even 100 years. Am I not a car?
No.
Are you sure?
Yes, sir.
So does it mean for the fact that you come to church every 10 years, does that make you a Christian?
No.
Oh, you don't want to answer me?
No.
For the fact that you have been coming to the church for the last 5 years, does that make you a Christian?
No.
There is difference between God calling and those who call God. Are you listening to me?
Yes, sir.
Are you listening to me?
Yes, sir. Very good.
Today is your day.
Yes.
If there is something I hate most, it's coming to the presence of God. And people will be going home, sharing other people's testimony. He said, Mama, you don't know what happened. Do you know that sister who was sitting to me? As the man of God was ministering. So they touched the sister. I don't know. But they said it's Holy Spirit too. He touched the sister received. And he was sharing testimony. I said, that is what I hate most in my life. I said, today, let it be you. Let people talk about your testimony. Many years, but you don't even know how the Spirit of God moves. You have never experienced the move of the power of God. You see, they say sometimes they pray, some people go, they fall. Why did they fall? You don't even know. One day, it will be your turn in Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I want to give you four keys. The first one is you miss your way. And when you miss your way, you will never get to your direction. And we have good example of some of them. King Solomon, King Saul, King David, even Peter. But I'm going to give you some scripture backing, just for the purpose of record. King Solomon is in 1 Chronicles 22:9, 1 Chronicles 28:9, 1 Kings 11:1-40, then King Saul, 1 Samuel 9:15-16, 1 Samuel 11, 1 Samuel 13:13, 1 Samuel 15:11-22:18. King David, 2 Samuel 12:9, 1 Kings 15:5, Ezekiel 18:20-26, 1 John 3:15. Apostle Peter, Matthew 10:20, Matthew 10:32, Matthew 26:31-34, Matthew 26:69. And then Judas Iscariot. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Number two. The first one is you miss your way. Number two is lack of speed. Lack of speed. Slow. Slow. From where we read in the book of Genesis, from chapter 27, verse 1, it said, and Isaac called his son Esau. He said, go and prepare for me that food that I love most. Because I can see my time is getting close. That after I finish eating, I will do what? Some of you are here for how many years now? You've been in this church worshiping. Not even one day. You feel seeming fit. Let me even bless my father in the Lord. It doesn't matter. He doesn't need it. But that attracts the blessing. It is the anointing you believe in that works for you.
Yes.
It is what you sow you will reap.
Right.
You cannot reap from where you did not sow.
Right.
Ah, daddy, daddy, every time daddy, daddy, mommy, mommy, it's always problem. Let me tell you something. That's another topic of his own. I was wondering if I have the opportunity someday, I'll come and tell you about Mother Rebecca. You had when the information was passed to Esau. Rebecca was always there. And Rebecca said, come Jacob. We are talking about what? Transfer of what?
Wealth.
The wealth of Esau was transferred to Jacob. Is that true?
Right,
who ate it?
The mother.
Who ate it?
The mother.
So when you are not in good relationship with your mother, do you know that you are already in trouble?
Yes, sir.
Do you know you are already in trouble?
Yes.
When you are not in good relationship with your mother, when the blessing were meant for who? Esau. It was meant for who?
Esau.
Jacob meant to bless who?
Esau.
And Jacob prepared the blessing for who?
Esau.
But son has somewhere with the intervention of the mother, the blessing were transferred to who?
Jacob.
Oh, come on, somebody. Are you in this house?
Yes, sir.
When you are not in good relationship with your mother, even if the blessing is already at the tip of your hand, you know it can slip out.
You are right, sir.
If you read deep down in Genesis 27, it says immediately after Jacob was blessed, Esau came in. It was too late. Too slow. A lack of speed. Some of you are cutting the call and you are cutting the vision, but you are too slow. You have not run with your vision. You need to run with the vision that God has given to you. If Esau were fast, he would have received that blessing. Every spirit of delay that is holding you in every area of your life, if I be truly man of God, today you are liberated. In the name of Jesus. Some of us here, we know the right thing, but to do the right thing is a big problem. Some of you need somebody to push you, force you before you move. If you follow that direction, you will not get there, you will not receive your blessing. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The third one. Unforgiveness. Unforgiveness. So many of you here have been so crushed. You have been so mistreated, have been abused, and you are finding it so difficult to forgive. Yes, I understand. I was once there, but thank God I am no more there.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I was once there, but I am no more there. According to the Bible, the book of Matthew chapter 6, from verse 9, our Lord Jesus taught us his prayer. How many of you know the prayer here? Do we know it?
Yes.
Let's do it together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth
as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us.
Stop. I want you to take that place. That's where I want to get. And do what?
And forgive us our debts as we forgive those who have us.
Did you know the meaning of that word you just said?
Yes.
Do you know the meaning of that word you just said?
Yes.
You think you do, but I don't believe you do. You think you do, but I don't believe you know it. And forgive us our sins. As we do what?
Forgive
those who trespass against us. You don't know the implication of what you have just said. You say, don't treat me the way I treat those that have offended me.
Hey.
Is that what that's what you just said?
Yes.
Hey.
And forgive us as we forgive those. Treat me the way I treat those that have offended me.
Yes.
That's what you are saying.
Yes, sir.
Do you mean it?
Yes.
Do you truly mean it?
Yes, sir.
So when you don't forgive, you have done the person no harm, or rather you are only doing yourself harm. When I offend him now, and I do not forgive him, he may not even know that I offend him. He may not have grievances, but the moment I see him, my heart will be pounding me. I will be disturbed. For he will be living so happily, doing his own things. Who is suffering?
You.
Who offend who?
You.
He offended me. Why should I suffer? He is the one that has offended me. Who is the one suffering?
You.
So why should I suffer when he has offended me?
Yes.
Do you understand that?
Yes.
So when you forgive, you have done the person no good. You have only done yourself a good. And when you see him, you will be smiling. You know what you did to me, but I forgive you.
Hallelujah.
If it is conscious, I will be wondering.
Yes,
he will be biting himself. Hey, that thing I did to him, and yet he's still behaving like this. What kind of human being is he?
Hey.
Is somebody in this house?
Yes.
It's a man of God, you don't know what he did to me. It's so bad, even if it's you, you will not forgive. But I'm telling you the truth today. Let me help you again. Supposing I bring a cup here, fill it with poison, and I begin to drink it, and I say, you die, die, die. Will you die?
No.
Why?
Yeah.
Oh, because I'm the one drinking the poison.
Yes.
So when you hold on forgiveness, you're only drinking poison and you're saying the person should die.
Yes.
And then in this condition, how can you expect the transfer of wealth to come to you? How? When you hold on forgiveness, you can never make it.
Yes.
You can never. You can never. There's no magic. No magic indeed. And because of unforgiveness, which will lead to the fourth part, the fourth key, so that I will run the message off because of time, which is the heart of gratitude. When you have unforgiveness, you find it so difficult to appreciate. Because you are always very careful. You are always very mindful. You want to make sure that what happened yesterday cannot repeat itself today. So because of that, even the little things people do, you want to use microscope to check and try to look the left, the right, the way. When everybody is even saying it's good, you will say, hey, but you will always find the but. And when you don't have the heart of gratitude, you can never receive. If you read the book of 1 Kings, I think that should be chapter number 6. Let me be very sure. The Solomon gave birth. David was the father of Solomon. David killed the father, the man that was supposed to father Solomon, and married the mother illegally. Is that true?
Yes.
But even despite this, David has the heart of gratitude. And because of the heart of gratitude, God said, run and look. And he said, David is the man after my word.
Yes.
I am not telling you that you must be perfect, but I'm telling you that you must learn to appreciate little things.
Yes.
If you cannot appreciate, those who don't appreciate don't give testimony. Take note. You see so many people here from January to December, they have no testimony. Does it mean God has not done anything for them?
No.
Because they don't know how to appreciate God. And when you cannot appreciate God for the little finger, you cannot get a full hand from God.
That's right, sir. That's good.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The heart of gratitude. You must learn to appreciate whatsoever God has given to you. When Solomon appreciated God, God forgot the past. God forgot how Solomon was given birth. David has so many children. Is that true?
Oh, yes.
But God said, no, this one, this product of fornication, this product of adultery, this illegal type is the one that I have chosen, through which will build my own house.
Hallelujah.
Attitude of gratitude. Be grateful to God. So many of times we wait for something to happen before we appreciate God. As you were coming this morning, supposing there was an accident and everybody in the car died, and you even break up your leg, you will come here with the half leg and say, praise God, God has done it again. Yes, everybody in the car died, but I have one leg. Thank God with my one leg I can still continue. Is that true of us? But you came to church, you wake up, you slept, you wake up this morning, you are sad, you are heady. You come to the church, you are saying, praise God, you can't even open your mouth to praise God. They say, praise the Lord, you find it difficult to praise God. Clap your hands, you find it difficult to clap your hands. Dance, you find it difficult to dance. Hey, come on, what do you think God needs from you? The only thing that you can give to God is praise. And when you come to his presence, when you are supposed to receive from him, when you are supposed to show some appreciation, you find it too big, you find it too dignified, you want to socialize yourself, you want to systemize yourself, you don't want to get out of your comfort zone, you will think people are praising God, you are just... I pray that that neck will not be stiff. Some people, when they have the privilege or the opportunity and they go to disco, you will see them coming up. And when you come to church, you cannot turn aside down for God. I'm sorry for you. And then at the ninth month, you want to push. And you want to deliver. What do you have in you that you want to deliver? Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
I'm sorry for the time. It wasn't a very good time. But I would have loved to really. I know one day we are going to come in and we're going to get it done. Appreciate the things that God has done for you. Appreciate one another. Look to your brother and say, hey, brother, I like this, your dress. It's fine. Look to your sister and say, Auntie, God has blessed you. Don't jealous. Don't envy what people, what God has given. Ah, you see that sister? Now when she did the church, every day she did give testimony. Every day now she did God did it for. Every day, if you not close out your Holy Ghost. Celebrate those who God has lifted.
Celebrate with them.
If you cannot celebrate those who God has lifted, how would you get the ladder to climb together? How? It's practically impossible. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
I know my time is almost up. Can I still have some time? I would have loved to go deeper, but I won't go deeper today. So, but I want to draw this message to an end by advising, giving you an advice. When we say an advice, it's an advice. It doesn't mean you must do it.
Yeah.
If you like, you do it. If you like, don't do it. It's not by force. It's not by what? Force. If God, who sent his only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, to come down to this earth, to die for me and you, could not force me, neither you, to do anything, who am I to force you to do something? Who? I am nobody. I am not even your father. Maybe you are even older than me. And I'm not your mother. So who is me to tell you what you must do? But I'm just giving you a tip. I'm giving you what? A tip. We call it Expo. Pastor, close your ear. You wouldn't listen to this. Hallelujah, somebody. Hallelujah, somebody. You see, I have given you four major keys. Apply these four keys in this month of transfer of wealth. I bet you, as I stand here as an apostle of God, as I speak, as you listen to the sound of my voice, I will not lay hand on you, but if you will take these words that I've given to you now and put them into practical action, I assure you before on the 15th of this month,
amen,
your testimony is better. I am so proud to say to you people that I'm an Urobo man.
Oh, yes.
And that is why I'll end this message with Urobo.
Yes, Lord.
I'll give you one simple song. Okay, my Jesus, when me run on when Jesus was rounding up the message, he now said, let those who are here, let them,
yeah.
Let them,
yeah.
Supernatural inspiration. It defines nature. It defines protocols. You know, don't have a vision that you don't understand. And even people don't understand. It must be plain. Many young people, they've heard the message of mentors, of destiny, helpers.